Maybe you are here because you have never made a budget before, or maybe the budget method you currently use just isn't working for you, or maybe you're just interested in see how I budget my money. Either way, the method that I have, the four-step process, is a method that anybody can do to help them create an effective, efficient budget. If you are new here, my name is Jennifer, and on this channel, I talk about saving money and living a simple life. We're also documenting our journey to paying off our mortgage by the year of 2024. And we are in the middle of financial, January 1st to the 12th. I do videos all about saving money and simple living. If any of that interests you, make sure you click on that subscribe button. So this is how to do a budget when you just don't know where to start. Now, how I came up with this budget method, or how I took all different kinds of budgeting methods and probably spent a good 2 years testing out different budgeting methods. So I will save you some of the work. Now, what works for me may not work for you, but maybe something that I do, one or two of the steps, could work for you and help you create a budgeting process that's personal to you. And I think budgeting is a very personal process. So the first step is a step that you really only have to do one time, and it's when you don't really know how much you spend on things. And it is a little bit more time consuming, but it will really give you the best picture to start off with what's called a zero-based budget, where you just start off not knowing, you know, what numbers to put in. So it's very simple. So first, you're going to print out 3 months of bank statements. And if you use a credit card, print off 3 months of credit card statements. And then you're going to choose probably 3 to 4 different highlighter colors, and you're going to go through all of your expenses. You're going to find out, you're going to take maybe green, you label for groceries. So every time you have a grocery, you've gone to a grocery store, you mark that off. Maybe red is for gas, and maybe, you know, pink is for just wants or need or wants and things. And maybe you've got a yellow, which is for, you know, household expenses, mortgage, utilities, etc. And you're going to lump these expenses into categories. And what you're going to then do is go through and each month add up, you know, how much money you spent on groceries. So everything that was highlighted green. And for those 3 months, you've got a total. Okay. So let's say you've got $400 here, $500 here, and $600 here this month. Well, the average that you've spent is what? I don't know, $500. Is that the average? So you can use that average as a base point. So when you go to your grocery budget and you start writing down the numbers, you're going to put that you usually spend about $500 a month on groceries. So you're going to do that for all of your items. Now, one thing that may fluctuate for me, it does, which is utilities. So gas, electric, and air conditioning. So I kind of lump that different, and I'll show you how I do that. But things that are static, which are really easy, you know, your mortgage or your rent or your, you know, car payment, those are easy. The things that are a little bit more fluctuating are going to be, you know, the grocery budget, the gas budget, the eating out budget, the wants budget. Those are the ones you really want to focus on in this process. So the last part of this first step is to go in and use those bank statements to determine when bills either come in and you pay them or they're due. So for instance, your utilities, your electricity, your gas, water, determine a kind of an idea of when you've been paying those. Hopefully on time, if they've been paid on time. So if you can see that, you know, 1 month you paid the water bill on the 23rd, the next month it was the 24th, the last month it was on the 22nd. So go ahead and just determine and pick the 23rd as the date that your water bill is due. If your mortgage is due on the 15th, but you pay it on the 5th, that's easy. So you're going to find these, not groceries, other things. You're going to find the actual bills that you pay that are reoccurring monthly expenses and find what date you pay those bills and write that down. Okay, step two of this process is to print calendars. You can use your calendar in your planner. You can use a wall calendar. I like to print out calendars. So I'll do at the beginning of the year. I do this for my budget, and I also do it for meal planning, and I put it in my meal planning binder. But I go to print-a-calendar.com and I print for free the calendar for the year. So what you're going to do here is, you know, different color pens. This is where you can get creative and fun. Is what you'll do is write down when you get paid. So for me, I get paid twice a month. I get paid on kind of the first. It's usually the last day of the month, but I consider it the first. And then I get paid on the 15th. So I put paycheck one and paycheck two. Because what I do here is a modified monthly paycheck to paycheck plus envelope budget. It may seem confusing, but just stay with me. So you've written down your paychecks, and then what you're going to do is you're going to fill into the calendar your bills. So when things are due. So you've gone through your bank statements, you've done that first bit of work, and you're gonna write, you know, your cell phone, you usually pay it on the 5th. You usually pay your mortgage on the 4th. You usually pay your car payment on the 27th. You usually pay your electric on the 25th, etc. So once you have put all of the monthly reoccurring expenses on the calendar, then you are going to go in and look for anything that you may have missed that's not a reoccurring expense. So for instance, something that's a special event. So you've got an anniversary coming up, or a birthday, or perhaps a wedding on the calendar, and you know that you're going to need to spend money on that birthday gift, anniversary gift, a dinner out, or, you know, a wedding gift for the new couple. You're going to put that on the calendar as well. Now, if it's, for instance, the wedding is in June and you're buying a present in May, you're just gonna put it on one of the dates in May when you plan to go and buy that. Also, put on here anything that doesn't happen maybe more than once a year. So if I know I'm taking the dog to the vet in January, I'm gonna write vet visit on here. Or if my Amazon Prime membership comes up in January, I'm going to write that on here. You know, the reoccurring, they don't reoccur monthly, but they, you know, occur randomly, or they're just special events throughout the year. So once you have this, what you're going to determine from this calendar is, this is how just kind of my brain works with this, is paycheck one is going to pay for everything that happens within that 2 weeks. So that money coming in is money that I'm paying towards the mortgage, towards my cell phone, and towards the dog visit, okay? And then paycheck two, I'm paying insurance, gas and water, electric, the car payment, and tires. I put down here tires, you know, again, this is a sampled mock because that's another just random thing. And maybe at the beginning of the month, you know, oh, well, I actually need to buy new tires this month. Put that on here because you know it's going to happen. So step three is actually where you write out the budget. And you can write this out on a blank piece of paper. You can write it vertically. You can write it horizontally, however you want to. But essentially, I'm budgeting per paycheck. So I'm going to take paycheck one and how much ever paycheck one is, put it here. And then I'm going to list out the expenses from the calendar that were supposed to come out of paycheck one. And then I'm also going to do that for paycheck two. Now for utilities, I do that different. I kind of lump that cost because the water kind of usually stays around the same, but the electricity and gas vary. Electricity is higher when air conditioning in the summer, gas is higher for heat in the winter. So I just kind of put an overall budget, and then whatever these usually work out to will come up to a total of that amount. So you're going to do an expense, name the expense line, and then you're going to do a budget, actual and a difference. So you're going to go back to this sheet. So keep it somewhere. It's in your planner or in your journal or someplace, you know, stuck to your refrigerator, where you can go in and determine how much you spent. So once you pay the mortgage, you're going to put $1,200 here, and you're going to put difference zero. Well, once you pay the gas here, so for instance, you went through the bank statements and you determined you spend about $90 average on gas for your car each month, but you've added it all up for the month and you actually only spent 86. So you put 86 here and the difference is $4. You can imagine this is going to help you over the first 3 months. It's going to fluctuate. It's going to look weird. You're going to be over here, under here. It's a learning process for you to figure out the best numbers for you as far as how much to allocate. But the whole idea is to ensure that the numbers that are expenses equal out to zero of your income. So you want at the end of that paycheck for it to be completely gone. Now, keep in mind, I've got savings here. So any money that was left over after my bills, my wants, my needs, is money for savings. Or if you're really having trouble saving money, put savings at the top and make that a priority, and then take your money, your budget out of that. So let's talk about the two kind of areas in a budget that fluctuate. That is going to be groceries and other. I do not individually budget for things like eating out, for things like new shoes, for things like, I don't know, lighting for my YouTube channel. I don't budget out for that. I take that out of an other budget, meaning it's a lump of money that I can spend on, you know, needs, wants. This is where I would also go out and, you know, if I'm replacing the air filter, I'll put that in there as well. It's just because, you know, I'm trying to simplify my life. It's a lot easier for me to have one lump in one bucket and kind of go off of that amount than try to be so detailed and have 20 lines in a budget. That is just too much. I ain't got time for that. So on here, one of the things that you think about when you're doing groceries or other, so in this kind of mock budget, under groceries for paycheck one, I've put $200. Well, under groceries for paycheck two, I've put $300. So why is that? Well, what I have done is you go into your calendar, and I go grocery shopping on Saturday. So there are two Saturdays within paycheck one. And I have already determined that I spend about $100 a week on groceries. So that would be $200. Paycheck two is one, two, three Saturdays. So I spend $100. That's $300 there on groceries. Now, I use that same idea when I look at my other budget because, you know, if I've got an extra week, 5 weeks in a month, and that paycheck two has to cover the other expenses for that third week, then it needs to be a little bit higher. Same thing for gas. So in gas on paycheck two versus one, I had 90. This one I have 125. For other, in this instance, I have $300. Now keep in mind, I've also gone in here and I've added vet visit, $175. You know, just take a kind of an idea of what you think that might cost. And down here, I know I wanted to buy tires, so I gave myself a budget of $250. So at the end of the month, you're gonna put your actual and your differences. And you're gonna write out, and you're, let's see, your difference down up here is negative $50. But this paycheck, you had plus 100. Then for the month, you were plus 50. Take that 50 and put it in savings or paying off your debt. You can see where we're going here. Now, one of the things you may wonder is, well, gosh, this is simple to fill in, but how do I track all those other expenses? Let's move on to the last step. So step four is a modified version. And I'll tell you, I got this idea from Jordan Page from Fun Cheaper Free. I'll try to find her video and link it down below. Otherwise, all you have to do is put into YouTube Fun Cheaper Free or Jordan Page budget envelope and it'll pull up. And she's gonna give you, you know, some great ideas on this, but I've kind of taken it and modified it a bit to work better for me. It's also where I got the other budget. I just thought that was genius. Again, I've taken little bits from so many different methods to create this method for myself. So what this is I carry it, I fold it up and I carry it with me in my purse. So whenever I make a purchase outside of, you know, the reoccurring purchases that you know what the amounts are, I write it down. So I've divided it again between the two paychecks and two categories. So the categories that fluctuate are groceries and other. And they are the ongoing categories. So what I'll do is every time I go to the grocery, so say I go to Aldi, I'll write Aldi, I'll write the date, say it's January 3rd, and I'll write $68. And then I'll say I went to Harris Teeter, had to go grab just a few odds and ends, that was January 15th, and I spent $35. So at the end of, from January 1st through the 14th, I'll put how much I spent. My budget was $200, and then I'll be able to determine, so let's say I spent $180. Well, I was positive $20. Same thing here, I'll do for the second week. And then when I get down here, I'll take the $180. Let's say I spent $200 here, then I spent $380 overall. And you'll go back in to this when you're kind of closing out the month. And if you spent $180, just put $180 here and you had $20 extra. Here, you spent $300, you spent $300, zero difference. So you're going to do the same thing with your other budget. So let's say I go to Belk and I get a new blazer, $68. Let's say I go and I buy a pair of shoes for my daughter at Rack Room for $25. And I go to Target and I don't remember what I got, but I spent $150, that total. And I was over budget. If I'm already over budget in week one, what I will automatically do is take it out of week two. And I'll know I need to be extra conservative. So if I've spent $50 over in week one, then I will change this and mark it out to $250 because I need to try to stay within my budget. So the other great thing that Jordan Page talks about is just putting your receipts in here. So if you get to the end of the month, every time you put this in, you get back in your car from doing the shopping, you write it down, you put the receipt in here if you were actually doing shopping, and that way, let's say you didn't understand why you were over budget and you really need to go back and look. Well, you know what? Look at all that stuff I bought from Target for $150 that I didn't need. Now, that isn't going to be the case with online purchases. You still want to write them. Let's say you order something off of Amazon. You still want to write it here. So if you need to research that later, you can. You can go back and see what you spent on it because you have the date, so you'll know exactly. This is not a long, overdrawn process. It is a little bit longer in the beginning. The first part about printing out the bank statements is probably the most that you have to do, and then determining the dates things are paid. But then when you have this calendar, it is super easy to transfer over to the next month. So you can see the second time you do this, you've already done the work ahead of time. You've already gone through and determined what dates you pay things, so you just move them over to February. Say February 4th, pay the mortgage. February 6th, I pay the cell phone. Same thing with this budget. You've already lined it out here. Heck, you can take this and put it in a work document and just print it out and use it for the next month. And maybe you need to modify some things, which is going to happen. You aren't going to have vet visit on next month. You aren't going to have tires on next month. Maybe next month is your dad's birthday and you change that out. Or maybe next month you determine that you want to start a sinking fund for your vacation. So you want to make your other budget less and add a sinking fund here. You modify it by that, but you've already done the work to determine how much you usually spend on things and where you need to be to reach your goals. So this is already completed. So the next month, again, you're just transferring it over to your calendar. You're just writing in pretty much probably the same stuff for the reoccurring payments. Your paycheck's probably the same. And the things that are going to vary, it's not going to take you long to figure that out. Same thing with this. You're just going to take from the budget that you wrote out and draw out some lines, put how much you had budgeted for grocery and for other, and carry it into that next month. I hope you got something out of this and it helps you maybe to create your own personal budget. It's just what worked for me, and I think all those people who came up with the different versions that I kind of took ideas from to develop into this version, and please feel free to do the same with me. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you back for more videos.